One teacher rushed to the hospital after multiple fights break out inside a Metro middle school. News 4's Peyton Yeager is live from John Marshall. That's near Northwest 15th, 115th in Stratford. And Peyton, this school has only been open for a couple of weeks now following the big Pathway to Greatness reshuffling.
Yeah, Kevin, this middle school has a whole new batch of students ranging from 5th to 8th grade, and this violence has parents scared to drop their kids off and teachers afraid to come to work.
I'm not able to protect my kids.
A scary thought that's now on LaVonna's mind. Her two daughters enrolled here, John Marshall Middle School.
Kids having to get pepper sprayed, kids getting put in handcuffs.
That's exactly what happened Monday afternoon, the second week of classes. A number of brawls breaking out, some caught on camera. A mob of mass chaos. Students rushing the doorway, a security officer tackled to the ground. Another video showing students swinging at each other. At the bottom of the dog pile, a female teacher. Punched several times while trying to break the fight up, falling back and hitting her head on a fire hydrant. An ambulance rushing her to the hospital with cracked ribs and a concussion. Staff members telling News 4 two other teachers intervened, one of them in a wheelchair. He took to Facebook saying, "I myself was hit and repeatedly pushed around while attempting to protect the teachers on the ground. I have been cursed at every day and truly teach in fear." Police say three students were cited for disorderly conduct. News 4 has been trying to get answers from Oklahoma City Public Schools since Monday afternoon. They've declined multiple requests for an interview, and more than 24 hours later, will only say that their teacher sustained a minor injury. As for how the students will be disciplined, they only say it will be according to John Marshall's student code of conduct, but refuse to elaborate.
And I just really want my kids out of there, but I have no other options.
Now, police tell us there could be more suspects involved. They're still interviewing students and all the staff. Reporting live, Peyton Yeager, Oklahoma's News 4.